So he asked, "Our governor, anyone have some better ideas?" I, Mark Stewart Greenstein, do. Governor Lamont, you've heard some of them already. This was way back about a year ago. It's time to hear them out and hopefully take me up on some of them. I am willing to do almost all of these myself. Just empower me with a Rolodex and a phone, and you can do the rest. So starting, number one, most important of all 20, Connecticut Commerce, the international version. Sir, we are an appealing place for business. You can help make it more appealing with some smart legislation that you push, but let's push ourselves onto business. German business, Lithuanian businesses, African businesses, Latin American businesses, Asian businesses, let them site divisions here. They'll have an open market to the U.S., employ some of our people along the way, and defeat any trade barriers that Trump's been putting up. Number two, Connecticut Commerce, the domestic style, meaning we start wooing companies from New York and New Jersey, whose government regimens are even worse than ours, okay? They're more oppressive. They need to see the charms of living in bigger houses with swimming pools for less price, not being cloistered near 1,800 neighbors, some of them who smell, not having school systems that you have to avoid by paying up for private schools, having less crime, having more opportunities for colleges. Connecticut's got that over New York and New Jersey, so send some of our good, attractive, well-spoken people. Send Annie, okay? Your wife is a charmer and talented and knows New York business already. She'd be great. All right, number three. You knew it was coming, right? You gotta bring these guys back or some NHL team to enliven Central Connecticut. We're worthy. We can hold our own for owners to make money, or at least not lose a lot of money. And look, an owner doesn't need, if he already has $2 billion, he doesn't need an extra couple million a year. He needs a frothy spirit. We already have that. You would put Connecticut on the map as an NHL city, a major league city. We are the largest state after Alabama not to have a major league team inside or on our border. That can change. Number four, first 500 schools. I've asked for this for a long time. Dan Malloy had a first five for companies. Not a bad idea, didn't work out great. First 500 is what moves families here. We already have a good advantage in education. It's well recognized Connecticut schools are good. So push that advantage. Help entrepreneurs start new schools. Back it with state loans in case things go bad. Generally, it's privately funded, but with the state's imprimatur on the goodness of developing schools and not being stocked in with big administrative bureaucracies, you're going to see new schools and new families that follow. Oh, and with new families, more tailors, more restaurants, more landscapers. That's the kind of small economy that builds up around them. Big economy, it's number five, sell submarines and surface ships to Asia, okay? We sell two subs a year and we make a lot of money, but the Pentagon may stop or drop to one. Why not press our know-how and help our allies in Asia fend off threats? Probably that threat is China. So don't you think the Japanese, the Koreans, Indonesians, Philippines, wouldn't they want one or two boats a year? We make them, we should be distributing them. Next, use our state employees to do other states' work. We're not as bad as Massachusetts and New York. We could actually help them and make money when they outsource their bad bureaucracies to our leaner, meaner, better paid state employees. Okay? And it's a nice way to start to privatize the really good state employees who have become entrepreneurial about their services. Actually bring in other state businesses. They may peel themselves off a CBAC. You won't have to fight with unions. Next, privatize the nice but not necessary services. It's the easiest way to cut the budget. Next, buy out retirees. Okay? There's a number at which retirees who aren't expecting 100% will compromise for. And that buyout means savings for us. Number 10, take 5, okay? 5 months. Number 10, stop paying people. It's ending welfare. It's overdue. Almost everybody who is incentivized the right way does go to work. Ask Bill Clinton, who against his instincts was persuaded to end the endless at the time welfare benefits at the federal level. And lo and behold, people got jobs. Not just a few people. We had probably the most roiling economy of the century in the late 1990s after Bill Clinton put this through. You should do this too. Now, specific proposal. There's one group that I would actually pay to not work, but to also leave. They are those who refuse. And if after 5 months of not doing anything, they lose their apartment. Okay, why should we be paying for people who just want to stay at our expense? Could work, don't want to. Some people might take the money and run. Fine, okay? Take 5 months, you got a nice down payment to somewhere in Ohio or Michigan, and leave. Because we don't want you on the payroll for 50 more years. Number 11, start a cybercrime institute, okay? It could be an adjunct to UConn or any of our state universities. It's something that'll attract people who want to go into the security field and want to protect us against probably the worst type of crime that's affecting us. We are fairly low, thankfully, about violent crime, but we have a high level of crimes against our pocketbooks, in part because we're a wealthy state. We could also outsource those services. Once we're really good at protecting Connecticut residents, we sell our skills to the FBI and to other states so that they can crack down too. Number 12, give parents choice in schools. That means ending education cost sharing. It's gone when you let parents go where they want to, armed with a voucher. Number 13, suspend zoning laws and labor laws so that people in Eastern Connecticut can get those foundations rebuilt. The insurance companies are not going to come around. We don't have the budget to fund everybody out of the state. And here, you could help people who want to go into the trade start a career by apprenticing themselves for 6 weeks this summer to some skilled people who do know how to do foundations and who might even recruit them when they get done with their schooling, thanks to their hands-on experience. It's a great apprenticeship, and those craftsmen, the skilled ones, they'll get extra business because of it. They'll work really cheaply. It's a do-good thing. It's a win-win. You don't have to rely on lawsuits or insurance company benevolence, which probably ain't gonna come. Number 14, build 6 more lanes along the Merritt. I'll let you get home faster. No state money's involved, because investors will make money when people who want to get to New York faster, have to because of work, will pay to get no traffic. 6 lanes south of the Merritt. The right-of-way is there. You can use it. It might cost $20 billion. Investors will pay it because they'll be making back $2 or $3 billion a year. It's a good deal. Number 15, bring Puerto Ricans here to work. They're American citizens. Most of them know English pretty well. So we have a labor shortage, and they're really hurting still from the effects of Hurricane Maria. This could be an easy conduit, and it could help make Connecticut a model for good immigration. Okay, it's not technically international, but it is integration the right way. Number 16, international. Bring good people here via lottery. So many well-off people are in a long, long line to get to American citizenship. Make it instantaneous for maybe 30 families a year. Okay, you could do the drawings like they do on television for the lottery. Make it the immigration lottery. We'll raise lots of money and bring qualified families. Okay, they have to meet the standards that you and the General Assembly make. And then welcome to Connecticut. We'll take a lot of money in the process. Number 17, make an international gaming lottery. Raises a lot of money. Okay? We get $300 million a year off of our own citizens. Think what we would get if we offered Connecticut rewards to China. They're crazy for gambling there. Okay? Let's make some money off of that. Number 18, get us out of the federal tax system. I mean, extricate from unconstitutional things that are foisted on Connecticut. We spend far more than we get back through the federal taxation system. Let people who are conscientious tax objectors, won't use those federal services, or if they do, they'll pay for it. Let them out, okay? Be the best tax cutter any Democrat has ever seen. Number 20, get out of the compact with wealthy Indian tribes, okay? They've had a great run for 30 years, but now their compact is holding us back from getting more entertainment in more places and more revenue that goes along with it. My last ones all relate to UConn. So my last ones are that, one, stop recruiting high school kids. It's predatory. It lends itself to abuse and embarrassment. We have problems with just one, on the whole, well-meaning coach, and we're about to pay Cavanaugh a lot of money because of wrong NCAA violations. Those are just the ones that have been caught. There's probably assistant coaches that do stuff all the time. We'll have a good team by taking transfers. Take the kids who are the number six man on a five-man team. They're going to be sitting for the next couple seasons at their big school. Come here. We'll assemble a really good team with the number six kids that have proven themselves and are mature enough to not have to be considered prey by recruiters. Similar UConn change. I'd like to see our current students act as the Peace Corps to international places, whether it's work or volunteer or study. Send them the way JFK sent a lot of young people out in the 60s. We could do the same thing. And what comes back? Better kids of our own and people who've made friends with them that want to come visit. Good for tourism. Maybe they want to become students of their own. So it's like, ooh, I like Wesleyan. I'd like to come here. Conn College, Mitchell College. We'd all like to see these kids. Next, final on UConn. How about conferring a degree, a UConn degree, on students who do 4 years of work for manufacturing? I mean, do good as if you did good in class. Maybe you have to take a few extra classes in the humanities somewhere to make you what UConn would consider well-rounded. But I'll tell you, a graduate of 4 years of rock-steady work, good recommendations, not slacking off on the job, that to me is a more employable person down the road than somebody newly minted with just a degree and very little real work experience. Give them a degree, then people aren't in the quandary of, oh, I'm giving up a college degree to start off in the labor force. All right, I have a few little ones. Okay, these are on the fun side, so if you got one more minute, hear me out. Airbnb, you can do it with the executive mansion. I'll manage it for you. You'll get neat guests, we'll raise revenue. Next, sports Olympiad. It should be a governor's little Olympics, okay? Get all 50 governors. You can have competitions. They're individual, they're team. You can pit Democrats against Republicans. Watch out, Charlie Baker's very tall and strong. But you can do good. And finally, concerts in Bushnell Park. I argued that from day one. It would be really fun. It's right outside your window. Invite good bands every Saturday or Sunday. Saturdays in the park, right outside your governor's window. All right. Take me up on some of them. Have a good rest of the winter.